So I have a pretty good story, or maybe you can say a pretty bad story, with this question here. And because I really want to make this video, I actually bought a book so I can find the same question again. This question is actually from one of the previous actual SAT subject tests, Math Level 2. And in my opinion, this is a real analysis question, and the SAT is meant to be for high school students when they are applying to college. And I first encountered this question when I was volunteering teaching an SAT prep class at UC Berkeley via a student group called the PTPS, People's Test Preparation Service. And I was trying to explain this question to the students. I couldn't do it. Let's have a look. And before we get into the answer, I would just like to thank NordVPN for sponsoring this video.
First off, VPN stands for Virtual Private Network, and it's a server that protects your internet connection and privacy online. NordVPN is one of the best VPNs out there. It creates an encrypted tunnel for your data, it protects your online identity by hiding your IP address, and it also allows you to use public Wi-Fi safely. Secondly, NordVPN servers are super fast, so there is no sacrificing speed for security. And the best part is, if you use the link in the description, nordvpn.com/blackpenredpen, and you will actually get a huge discount on a 2-year plan. And if you use my code blackpenredpen, you can also get an additional month for free. So go ahead and check them out. And thanks to NordVPN for sponsoring this video.
So, do you think that this question is confusing, especially if you have never taken like a proof type of math class before? I think so. And you know what's worse? The answer for this question is none. Not only the language is just so mathematical, but also the answer is none. None of these. Okay, so let's go over how to answer this question. First off, what is the question asking? Which set has an element that is less than any other element in that set? This is how math people will write the question, but the truth is, we can actually read this in a simpler language. The question is just asking, which set has a smallest element? That's it. Because we want an element to be smaller than any other element, so that element has to be the smallest. That's it. And then of course we have these options, and just for practice, I wanted to show you guys how we can use the set builder notation to write this set. For the first one, we want a set of positive rational numbers, so here's the set builder notation, and let's use R. And first we want the R to be positive, so we can say R is greater than 0, and then we can put down a vertical bar, meaning such that, and then we are going to put down the property of what R should be. R has to be a positive rational number, we have the positive right here already. And then for R to be a rational number, it means it has to be an integer over an integer. So we can write this as A over B. But we have a fraction, so that means we cannot have 0 on the bottom. So we'll say B cannot be equal to 0. And then we also have to say A and B, they are elements, right? That's what this notation is for. The set of integers. So that's what the Z is for. And close that. In fact, this set has a special notation. The set of all the rational numbers is just Q, denoted like this. And if you want just the positive rational numbers, you can put on Q with a plus like so. All right? Now, for number two, we want the set of positive rational numbers. So we can say R. And we can say that first, we want R to belong to Q plus. So that means R is a rational number, and that's also going to be positive. Such that we want R squared to be greater than or equal to 2. So we'll put that down right here. So that would be the set builder notation for that. And then the third one, we want the set, again, positive rational number, so R belongs to Q plus, such that we want R squared to be greater than 4. So let's go back to here. Do we have a smallest positive rational number? The answer is no. Why? Because the answer is none. Of course, I'm just kidding. Here's the deal. All right, let's think about maybe we have, let's say, 1 over 10. It's a pretty small rational number, but is this the smallest? No, because if you say this is the smallest, I can prove you wrong. I can say 1 over 100. This is going to be a smaller rational number than 1 over 10. Well, if you say this, just put down 1 over 1,000, then you see that's not the smallest. This is smaller. You see, you can keep on going forever. Unfortunately, you are just not going to find a smallest positive rational number. If it says non-negative, right? If it says non-negative, if the set R is greater than or equal to 0, in fact, this set does have a smallest element, and the smallest element is 0. Because right here you see R is greater than or equal to 0, so R can be equal to 0. So 0 belongs to this set, and 0 will be the smallest non-negative rational number. Okay, now let's take a look at number 2. And per our discussion earlier, because we have the equal sign here, so we should have a smallest element, right? No. Because imagine you want to solve this inequality, take the square root on both sides, then you are saying R has to be greater than or equal to square root of 2, just a positive version because R is positive. Okay, again, we have the equal sign, so square root of 2 should be the smallest element for this. But the answer is no, because square root of 2 does not belong to the set of rational numbers. Square root 2 is not rational. I have a proof of that a long time ago. Go ahead and check that if you would like. But yeah, that's why number 2, it's not the answer either. Yeah. Okay, number 3. We want the set of positive rational numbers. So all that stuff, and R squared is greater than 4, yeah? Okay. Let's solve for this inequality, just take the positive root. So it looks like we have R is greater than square root of 4 is just 2. But you see, this time, we do not have the equal sign. We do not have a smallest rational number that's bigger than 2. So again, this right here does not have a smallest element either. If number 3 was saying this right here would have a smallest element, because 2 belong to this set, and then 2, in fact, it will be the smallest. So that's why it's none of this. So what do you guys think? Yeah, I was extremely confused when I was reading the question, because I was just beginning to learn about proofs, and I was not great in teaching, because that was like the first ever time I was standing in front of students and I was just a volunteer teacher. Yeah. So, good memory, I would say, but also bad memory. But anyway, hopefully you guys all enjoyed this. That's it.